So, let's get started. Let's quickly decrease the volume a bit. And let's check what we have on a to-do list. Teaser grid adjustments. Margin top and bottom. Okay. Maybe only top. So, then let's get started. First the next server, like caps lock. And this CMS too. Let's see what else we do have here. Error pages. Sounds like fun. Not. Bug fixes, bug fixes, bug fixes. Let's switch priority here. So let's see how far we can get with that. So maybe I will just change that and include a spacer component for that. Yes. So let's do a spacer component. So let's see if this thing is up and running. Seems so. Let's check the page. Okay, I would like to change that here, that image quickly. Let's go into the projects folder. I think I have like a rough picture of myself. Let's pick that. Me, myself, and I. So there I am. Let's go. So, in order to check the margins, I need the teaser grids. But let's do this on another page. Let's do this on our about page. Before that, we need some pages. No, that's actually content. No, let's cancel this. I want to. Hmm. Why can I delete this? What publish deletion? An error occurred. Yeah, done. Let's do this again. Yeah. No, it's not a section, it's a content. So, and another one. About this website. So, can't I just change the name? Can change the template, but I can't change the name. That's weird. Let's go into this. No, that's not possible to change. I have to delete this. Yeah, then let's delete this. So, and let's add this again. Page name is me. It's a content. And it is called about me. So, and another page named Open Project. Again, a content. Oh, that's German. So like this. So then let's edit this page and let's add those things. The pages we ju just created into a teaser grid. So teaser component. Headline is about me. Facts. So maybe that's a CV. And details. About me, color would be green. It's an internal link. The image, oh, it seems to be okay. We have made this a required field. That's not good. That's not what I want. So let's see. What I wanted to do is to check why this image here is required. That's in a teaser grid, and we have the teaser. Within the teaser, it shouldn't be required. So that might be the problem is okay, we are using the general image. I think we need to make a copy of that. And make it not required. Well, maybe we can. No, we let's just overwrite this. So, image alt caption. Let's try this. Whoa, 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 wait, 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 wait. Yeah. So So. Would be very excited if this works. So, let's see. So, we want the teaser component, and the image is not required. Awesome. Exactly what I wanted. So, let's recreate this about me. All things about me. CV and stuff. And color is again green, and I don't want to have this image. Select the link. That's me. Oh, client-side error. I don't see an error here. Let's check the console. Maybe also the template has the is expecting that we have an image. Let's check this. The image is not mandatory. It's actually checking for that. Maybe let's try this. If it has an image, then it should output. Let's export this for Magnolia. So, and let's look if it works now. So let's make this a little bit smaller and check again. And yes, that was it. Okay, so then let's create two or three another teasers. So I want another one. So I want about this website as a teaser. Technical facts and yeah, what should the text be? Technical text. Stack that drives this website. Like this, color would be red. Internal link again, and that's the website. Awesome. So last one. That's open project. Numbers and figures about my site hassles. So color would be yellow Because if I put this red, that would be a little bit weird, but it's deep red. So let's preview this in tab. So as we see, there's absolutely no spacing, and therefore we need a spacer component. So then let's create this. So first thing we need, let's create a new pass here called utils and a new component. So that will be spacer. Okay, then let's, what is in that is one. I can copy this as a starting point. So I don't want any component for that. That's, yeah. So we should have a property called spacing, which is a string number. Let's see. So we call this component spacer. And what do we render here? Maybe I should output the props for now. So, and we exporting spacer. Actually, that's so 2010 to have a spacer component, but it makes most sense. I don't want to introduce standard values. Yeah, maybe. Maybe I create a spacer component. So what should it be? What kind of tag? Yeah, it has no meaning, so it should be a div. So let's put it like this. That's enough for now. So then let's map this. So we call it util components. So and we map this to the CMS component. So like this. This has not been created yet, but let's export it for now. For now we are done here. And we should create this here as well. That's the dialogues. We need to create it in a template section first. So new directory utils, and we create a spacer jamel. Oops, that was the wrong dialog. Spacer jamel. And now, yeah, let's pick. Ah, no. I know what went wrong. We need to do it like that. I did that mistake just in the last session. So then let's components, utils, spacer, yes. All right. So and we can copy from the translation. That's so let's call this spacer component, and the dialogues for that will be in YouTube Spacer in the dialogue section as well. Let's create this. Oh, nope. YouTube, right? Yes. So let's create the spacer jammer here as well. The spacing. And I think I did that already for the image quality. But not here, but in the includes. So let me check. So there we have the quality. And yeah, let's just copy this over. So good, good, good. Okay, we need to create a dialogue first. So now I need to copy this over. And this is spacing. So default value. What is a good default value for spacing? I think 24 would be a good size. Let's see. Step size should be 1. Okay, let's see if this already works. So are we able? Ah no, I need to add this to the available components. So available components. So here we should have what I'm building. I can show you maybe. So at the moment I built my personal website. So oops. That was wrong. Yeah, that's not working right now. Maybe that's kind of a block and I want to promote. Yeah, that's my thinker. My comedian thinker pose is this. The image has to be fine-tuned, but yeah, I will use this on my website. Definitely. Thank you. So also I can show you some more if you want. So at the moment you are able to add like content stuff here. So I have the code component here to show code. Like this, and also I made a component for Markdown. Oops, why is the editor? Oh, something is wrong with the focus here. Yeah, what's the name of the CMS you are using? Or is it something you have built, the company built you are working for? What I'm using here is Magnolia. That's also has a community edition which is open source. But besides that, they have enterprise features. So this is how it looks like at the moment. Ah yeah, okay. And have you seen that I... Oh, okay. Yeah, that's with legacy CMS, which are built for by a company for a product, could be growing old and Backbone.js, I know that. Oh, that's 9 years. Yeah, I didn't touch Backbone.js since 9 years, but I liked it back then very much. Oh, there's. Ah, yeah, I see. I have some issues left. There's a lot of work to do until I can release this. Yeah, it was pretty easy. Yes, I use Next.js as the front-end rendering engine because this is kind of a. I agree. Next.js is really awesome. Especially if you want to have your website crawled by search engines and so on. So, and we want. What we want is. Yeah, we want to have the spacer here. Components. Utils spacer only available. So let me check if I'm able to add the spacer here. No, it's not there. Oh yeah, I know why. Because I cloned this area a couple of times. So let's see if we can add the spacer now. Yes. So, and yeah, let's go with the default sizing. And somewhere we should see the spacer with spacing 24. Okay. Float. Okay. Why is this a float? I need a converter for that. I want an integer. Oh. So for the text field, I need a converter which gives me an integer instead of a float. So let me check. Type converter class. So let's check what we get now. Where's the spacer? Still. Ah, I guess I have to delete this and create this again. Where is my spacer gone? Yeah, that's. Okay, then let's delete this. And I want to have this before. So now I have some errors here. Let me close this again. So I can imagine that I don't have this class. Oh my good converter class. That's already afloat, I guess. That's the reason. So what slider field? Ah. Okay. Should be a number. So let's check. No, it's even crashing. Okay, let's just convert this in a front end. That's so. Let's check. Component for that here. So then let's do the restructuring. So that's spacing. So and spacing value. So like this. Oh, let's check. This is, if this is there, then let's pass this, otherwise we have a spacer of 0. So like this. So and then let's apply this as a style. And let's use margin top. And spacing, spacing value, no, spacing reference like this pixel. So let's see if this works. We need to export this for Magnolia again. So let's check. No, that's doesn't work. Let's So this thing is not being rendered. I think I forgot to render this. No. Okay, that's weird. The spacer output. Do we still have it? Or did I? Maybe I removed this one. Yeah. Okay. There we go, but 24 seems a little bit, seems not enough. So where is the spacer component? So there we have it. That's 24 pixel. Okay. I think we need to, in order to make this look good. Hey, come on, error. Close. That's. No, why? I have. Step size is 1. Okay. So let's take 48 pixel. So let's check how this looks like. Better. Okay. Good, good. So I think we are through with that one. Next one would be catching errors. Oh my god. Good. Then let's get started with that. So that's already an error. So I know how to produce one. I will just note this down. So produce error by providing value format number to slider. So awesome. So we can produce an error. 404 is easy. So let's start with that. So we want to have some page that doesn't exist. So, okay. Okay, but this is the Magnolia rendered page. Is this even? No, that's not. So what we have to do is to check this in the port where on the port where Next.js is running. So this would be a 404 because it is not being met. So and when if we try to so image is not available, okay. So and if we try this, we get an empty. Okay, let's check. So then let's check what the API is. sending us. So, what do we get from get Magnolia data? That's the question. So this is the fetch, and we don't even handle the error at the moment. This needs to be handled. So the fetch method should have an error method. So, and in case we have an error, let's write this down. Well, let's choose the prototype, the pass. So let's think about it for a moment. First, I want to check what the main response contains for that case. That is 200. Ah, yeah, that's not. Okay, then let's request this page, which doesn't exist, and we still get the 200. That's weird. Ah. Okay. That's catched down here, and we get page JSON null. But what is the promise response? What is the response? Headers. Ah, this is already okay. That's actually, this should result in an error. Where's the lock? In the Magnolia. So is this even? Check where we have this. What was the URL again? AD. It's not even requested. That's weird. That's the slug. And the response we get here. Okay, we have a response, and the response is 200. Then let's check the response. interested what this will tell us about. Oh my god, that was the wrong response. That will always return something. That's... yeah. So... we need to have a look at this here. So that's the response we are looking for. Yeah, there we have a status of 4-4. So, and in the case of 4-4, we want to request the content of a 4-4 page. So, let me quickly check if this is available. So. Yeah, let's do it like that. So, if response status equals 4-4, then we are requesting the content of a 4-4 page. So that shouldn't be the page JSON endpoint. That should be 404 endpoint. So const not found endpoint equals like this for now, and this should override the response. Let me output this here. Just to check how this will look like. So okay. So that doesn't exist. That's true. So do we have this lag here? This and yeah, let's check what the response is then. The moment shouldn't find it as well. So what we need to do is to add such a page. So this should be of type content, 4-4, not found, so let's, no, this shouldn't have the header, or should it? I'm not so sure about it. Maybe. So add a spacer component with a spacing of 48. So below that I want to have the content grid, and within the content grid I need a headline. So, and this should say, yeah, 4-4, but found. So, maybe I can, yeah, that's enough for now. So let's check. No. So we should actually get the 404 page. But we don't. Are we in a... Is this the correct file? No, it's not. So, here... Oh! Two slashes is one too much. So then we don't need this. It's actually delivering this thing. Oh, yeah, no, it's working. So we are also, we should also like check the security app, because the image is not rendering and that annoys me a bit. So no. Where do we get this image from? At the moment, yeah, that's next image, it is not being rendered. So, but the reason for that is that that Magnolia doesn't expose this. I think I saw this, how to do that in the that documentation. So there we have the Hello Magnolia Headless content delivery IP permission for images. There we have it. Anonymous, okay. Anonymous. Edit role, and what does it say? Web access. So then add new and enter imaging. But only get, right? Get and post. No. No, no. So like this, let's see if this works. Not a bit, not now. Where, let me check where I find this image. So the API says, where do we have the header? There's the header. But it doesn't even contains the image. It doesn't even contain, yeah. That's for the 404 page. That's, ah yeah, true. We are not requesting. Yeah, okay, that should be part of this route here. And the image is in image. Weird. That's in DOM. Okay, then we need to give access to DOM as well. So, new. I think it should be DOM and get. So, let's check. And at least, yeah, okay, that took a while to render. Let's check if it is better the second time. Okay, awesome. Good. Then we have this fixed as well. So, I think we can safely remove this here. 404 page is done. So, if we have a 500 error, okay, we saw this. I just wrote down how we can achieve this by adding number to the spacer. Do we have what? There's the spacer component. Good, and I need to add this here. No, to the dialogue. So, and that was value format number should result in crash. So then let's check that. Doesn't crash. Yes. Why not? It crashed. Is only crashing here? No, it's not crashing. That's weird. But how do I crash the page then? Okay, yeah, I have no idea how to get a 500 error. Yeah, we should. Maybe we should just stop the server. The CMS server. So, Magnolia stopped. Let's see what we get here. So, there we get an error. That's amazing. Yeah, okay. So, let me check the Next.js documentation. What we can do in that case. Docs. Therefore, 500. Okay. Okay, seems to be easy. Can you get static props inside this page? Yeah, that's for later. Let's just create this page. Oops, forgot the point. Oh, that should be it, right? And React must be in scope. If it wants React, it gets React. Then let's do this. Do I have to do something else? No, I don't want to. So then let's check if we already achieve what we want. Nope. Okay, we have the 500 page. I guess this is because we are getting this error in get static props, don't we? Yes, okay. We get this error here, and it's just going in. Yeah, that's not a. Why is this not a 500 error? Server rendering an error page for every visit adds complexity to responding to errors. To help users get responses to errors as fast as possible, Next.js provides a static 500 page by default without having to add any additional stuff. Somehow I just did something that this default mechanism doesn't work. Is this because I created a slug here? Let's rename that for a second. No, I don't want to. That's just temporary. If I do this now, I get a 404. Okay. I guess then the reason is because I created a slug. Then we need to take care of the 500 error on our own. I guess it will also part of this. So, 500 error can also occur if the backend is not available. So we need to handle this somehow in the slug, I guess. we need to render something that isn't this. Where is my run task gun? Why is this gun? Ah. So. Actually, what it is doing, it is. So if we don't have the preview version here, which is for the author, we can just throw this error again. That could be an attempt, yes. Do we have... So, if not preview and not register preview, I want to throw this error again. So let's... Why I deleted this 500 page again? I don't know. So, and we need to have reactant scope. I wonder where this error is coming from. Error for pass. Okay, we already have this. So then, yeah, what we should do is, in that case, to redirect to 500. It's stringifying the error for us. Okay. Good, that is the point here. In that case we have this error, and what we want to do instead is to redirect. Actually we want to rewrite, but I'm not sure if this is possible. So, first we will need to include the useRouter hook. Like this. And in case... Yeah, but it's overwriting our URL. Actually, what we can do is to do just that instead. Yeah, that makes sense. So like this. Okay. So, but that's not how I want this. Actually, we need to style this a bit. Whoa, what happened? Ah, yeah, okay. Code completion. Fix. Then fix. And let's do this for now like this. So okay, let me start the server again that I know which styles I have applied. In between, I want to check what error pages. Yes. Good, 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 good. Oh, there's an error. Yeah, pause not found exception. Okay. Yeah, you won't find this. So for the full power page, we can make this a little bit better, I guess. So let's it already has been centered. Okay. So let's check. Yeah, that won't work, I know. So like this. And that needs to be margin top like this. And the classes are not available from here. So then I will need the content grid styles. They are from grid as CSS. Good, then let's import. Let's do it like this. So grid styles content grid, and I need to import grid styles. I guess it is here, okay. Then we need to import this grid styles from our package. Grid, I guess. Yes, no. No, let's. Does that work? No. Let's try this. Lib styles. Let me check. I must have done that before. Ah, okay, that's in a global. Then I should be able to just. Does that work then? So that's one folder up, styles global. No, yes, no. It's actually there. Maybe we should do it like that? No. Yeah, that works. But then let's check what. Global CSS cannot be imported from files other than your custom app due to the global nature of style sheets. Yeah, but I guess I. It is already imported. Then. Let's make that as it was before. And let's check what we get with the CSS there. I don't know exactly what is being loaded. That's not the. I need to stop the Magnolia again to get a 500 page. Yeah, now I get something cached. Weird. Okay. Oops, okay, that's. Yeah, but that only works as long as the styles. So what we need to do is something else. We cannot do it like that. We need to import the content grid actually and render this. So it should be 500 server error. So that looks how it should look like. So, and I... So the headlamp component, we should have this here somehow. Somewhere. That will be it. Numeric size should be the biggest size. What is the... Yeah, size should be 1. Or is it different? Now let's just try it out. So, and remove this. Then let's see what we've got. Still the same. Good sign. So, and content grid item, we don't need this. What we will do instead is to just use one div and remove this and remove this. And this is also not necessary. This. So we want to have it display flex justify content center align items. We don't even need the margin top here. Okay, let's check. So we need a height of 100% here. No autocorrection here. And we need a height of 100% here as well. So in the comma. Okay, this has 100%. Okay, then let's do it like this. So, there we go. Okay, that should be it. A little less conversation. So, if we restart the server, we should get a 404 instead. Just to double check that. Is still rendering 500, and let me check this. This renders a 404. All right, good. I need to add a point to my to-do list that I need to check the routing. Oh no, that's not. So. Check the routing for the root path. Good, that should be it for today.